make each other priority, which is that sense of somehow communicating that that person is a value in your life.
All right.
Your spouse may be the most important person in your life, but do you show it? When most of us tie the knot, we dream of a fairy tale romance.
But after years of daily demands and kids, some couples fall into a rut and they wonder what happened. News Channel 8's Cynthia Fodor talked to counselors and happily married couples to find out what helps rekindle the romance.
Shelley and Blake Wenzel cherish Tuesdays, their one day off together, to cherish each other.
We both work very strenuous jobs, so when we have the opportunity to hang out with each other, we do.
Instead of running errands, they look forward to lunch, to look into each other's eyes.
We have oysters Bienville, and just to keep the spice in our lives, we like to have a little oyster and good conversation and beautiful food to go with my beautiful wife.
After 9 years of marriage, the Wenzels realize the importance of a date night. They say take turns planning a surprise to do something fun and different. Ride rides at Adventureland. Spend an evening in a hotel with room service.
Maybe visit with some friends or go for a walk or have a picnic. So we change it up a little bit. Yep.
Yeah, it's important not to fall into a ride.
Exactly.
We get to kind of reconnect with each other after the week that we've had and just kind of relax and enjoy good food and each other's company. It really helps bring us back together.
Spending quality time will rekindle passion. Think of how you can be more sensual and romantic every day. A candlelit dinner, a massage, a bubble bath. Be imaginative. Marriage counselors say make the emotional connection and the physical will follow.
The most sexual thing that you can do is to understand the deep inner landscape of your partner.
Patrick McDonald says for sex to sizzle, you have to forgive. Recognize negativity and get over it. Don't let resentments build. Don't carry unresolved issues into another day.
And you can hold a grudge about anything, so it's a matter of willfulness to say, I really don't want to go there.
You want to get it done and figure out what the best resolution to the problem is and be done with it, you know. Don't need to hash it over and hash it over.
In the end, give each other a break. No one is turned on by a partner who is critical. A relationship can only thrive if you become a lover and lower your expectations. Some degree of dissatisfaction is guaranteed no matter who you're with over time. Choose to be loving and lovable, but not always predictable, to regain the magic.
People desire to be loved and to love. That deep hunger many times really compels people to stay on track and to work hard to reclaim or recapture that passion.
Cynthia Fodor, KCCI News Channel 8, Iowa's News Leader.